Hello students, a very warm welcome to the English class. Before I proceed, let me remind you that this class is brought to you by DK District PU Colleges Principals Association, and the program is recorded at Ambika PU College, Puttooru. Dear students, today we are going to take up the third lesson of your English course book Springs. The title of the lesson is On Children. This is a poem by Khalil Gibran. Let me give you some introduction about this poem before we continue. The poem On Children is chosen from a collection of poetic essays of Khalil Gibran. The title of this book is The Prophet. Khalil Gibran is a Lebanese American poet, writer, artist, philosopher. Gibran had an inclination towards the Eastern philosophy, Eastern ideologies. Though he belonged to a Western country, Khalil Gibran was born in Lebanon in a village called Basharri, and then he went to America and settled there after his teens. He died or passed away in the year 1931. About this book, The Prophet, from which this poem On Children is chosen for you. The book is a collection of poetic essays. I have already told you that the book, The Prophet, is a collection of 26 poetic essays. Khalil Gibran's poems are rather considered as poetic essays than being called as poems, because Khalil Gibran, he never followed a traditional style of poetry. His was a non-traditional type of poetry. It means he didn't follow the rhyming pattern, and the lines of the poem were of not equal length. There was no uniformity in the length of the lines written by him. Besides this, there are no equal number of lines in every stanza. So to that extent, we can say that Khalil Gibran's poetry is a non-traditional type of poetry. But still, Gibran follows a certain poetic devices which we are going to discuss as and when the lesson progresses. About the book, The Prophet, from which this poem On Children is chosen, this book had become so popular that the book has been translated into 25 languages. It itself is an indication that how popular the book, The Prophet, has become. These poetic essays of Khalil Gibran in the book The Prophet, they are almost like certain fables which contain beautiful thoughts written in a simple style. So saying, let us take up this poem On Children. Dear students, before we proceed, let me ask you a couple of questions as a pre-reading activity. Children, what do your parents expect of you? Usually the parents have a lot of expectation about their children. What are the expectations of your parents of you? I think many of our parents either want you to become exactly what they are. Some of the parents, they don't want you to become what they are right now. So there are many such wishes or the wants of your parents. What do you think? Do you feel somewhat like irritating when your parents want you to achieve something as per their wishes? Have you ever felt your parents are too possessive or demanding? If so, why do they think so, or why are they so possessive about you? Possessive, in a sense, I would like to give you an example. Many of the parents, they consider their children as a property, and as the property belong to them, they also consider that you also belong to them. So saying, they are very, very possessive or demanding. They have so many demands from you. So this is the pre-reading activity, and I think the answer for all these questions, if I put it in a nutshell, is like this. Many of us, the children, they don't like our parents being too possessive about ourselves. I hope I am right. So, before I proceed, before I discuss about this poem on children, let me read this poem, and I request you all to listen to me attentively. You can find a very nice picture about this poem on children, drawn by the artist. Here we go, the poem on children. And a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, "Speak to us of children." And he said, "Your children are not your children." I repeat, and a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, "Speak to us of children." And he said, "Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of lives longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, for they have their own thoughts. You may house their bodies, but not their souls, for their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you cannot visit, not even in your dreams. You may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. For life goes not backward, nor tarries with yesterday. You are the bows from which your children, as living arrows, are sent forth. The archer sees the mark upon the path of the infinite, and he bends you with his might, that his arrows may go swift and far. Let your bending in the archer's hand be for gladness, for even as he loves the arrow that flies, so he loves also the bow that is stable." This is the poem on children. Dear students, about the background of this poem, the very first line suggests this. And a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, "Speak to us of children." I have already told you that this poem on children is being chosen from Khalil Gibran's book The Prophet, and these poetic essays, almost 26 poetic essays of this book The Prophet, is nothing but the story of a prophet. Once he went to a kingdom and was there for many days, and one day he was about to depart from that kingdom. Before his departure, a large number of people gathered around him, and they started asking questions to him one after the other. And those questions were of different issues, like love, marriage, eating, drinking, religion, joys, sorrows, good, evil, etc. and etc. There appeared also a woman, a lady, who was carrying a small newborn baby in her bosom, and said, and she asked the prophet one pertinent question. And her question was to get the prophet's perspective or views about children. And she says, as it is given here in this poem, speak to us of children. She wanted to get the prophet's views or opinion about children. And he said, dear students, look at the second line, and he said, what does he here refer to? Does it refer to the child? Does it refer to the poet? Or does it refer to the prophet? I think you agree with me that the correct answer is, he in this line refers to the prophet. The prophet says, he said. Look at the third line, very, very interesting. Your children are not your children is the opening remark, the very first declaration is somewhat shocking to the mother perhaps. Not only to that mother, for any parent, when a particular person, a parent, asks a learned man like a prophet to tell him or her about children, and if they get the answer like this, just imagine how it would be. I think the prophet had hit the parents where exactly it hurts. He says, your children are not your children. Let us discuss about this line. Why does the prophet say that our children are not our children? Then whose children are they? If our children are not our children, then whose children are they? The following lines throw more light on this. But let us remember one thing, that all of us, I mean the parents, always think that our children belong to us only. That is an example of being possessive about children. We always consider that our children are our children. But according to the prophet, our children are not our children. Then whose children are they? And why is like that is given in the next line. Look here. They are the sons and daughters of lives longing for itself. Who does they refer to? Dear students, you have a chapter on pronouns in your workbook, the very first chapter, and some other lecturer will discuss about pronouns later. But here is an example to identify the pronoun and also find out what does that pronoun refer to. Here is a pronoun, they. They are the sons and daughters of lives longing for itself. Who does they refer to? They refers to the children. The noun mentioned in the previous sentence or line, your children are not your children. So children is the last noun appeared in the previous sentence, and therefore the first pronoun appears in the next line must refer to the last word which appeared in the previous line, children. They are the sons and daughters, children are the sons and daughters of lives longing for itself. Here is an expression, lives longing. What does lives longing mean? We will discuss about it now. You can find here the photo of Khalil Gibran, born in 1883 in Lebanon and passed away in the year 1931, a poet, though belonged to the western part of the world had an inclination towards the eastern philosophy and eastern ideology. And here you can find a lady carrying a baby in her arms. And a lady like this put that question to the prophet, speak to us of children. And the prophet says, your children are not your children. I have already told you that Khalil Gibran is considered, his poems are considered as poetic essays, because he does not adhere to the usual versification but uses certain poetic devices, which we are going to discuss in this poem later. Yeah, this is the summary or the notes of the poem On Children. On Children offers a critique of the usual expectations of parents about their children and urges them to introspect. Yeah, I had forgotten to mention about this. Let us have a quick look at it now. In the title of the poem is On Children, but the theme of the poem is this. Here it offers a critique of the usual expectations of parents about their children, but the prophet urges the parents to introspect themselves. How correct we are about our views towards our children, and where we have gone wrong. This is what the prophet is trying to do through this poem, and he urges the parents to introspect. Yeah, I have already told you that this prophet is about to depart from a kingdom, and then people of the land gathered around him and asked questions about his perspective on various issues like love, marriage, food, life, death, religion, good, evil, etc. and etc. Yeah. The very first sentence spoken by the prophet, just now I told you that it is somewhat shocking, it was a shocking declaration, your children are not your children. Now, one more interesting thing to notice here, I have told you that Khalil Gibran's poems are considered as poetic essays because he didn't follow the traditional style of poetry writing, but still, yet he followed certain poetic devices, and one of the poetic devices the poet has followed in his poem is the use of figures of speech. Here is a figure of speech in the line, your children are not your children. Dear students, can you identify the figure of speech found in the above line, your children are not your children? Think for a while. Your children are not your children. You can notice in this line two opposite or contrasting ideas. Two contrasting ideas are being given here, are found here. In the first part it says that your children, and in the last part it says that your children are not your children. So these are the two contrasting ideas or views. When there are two such contrasting views clubbed together and given in a sentence, and we call that figure of speech as oxymoron. Oxymoron is one of the figures of speech where two opposite ideas are joined together to create a new effect. In Kannada, we can give an example to this like this. Nivella helid mele nanige gottiddadu marthu hoyitu anta eshto sa naavu helodide. Nivu helid mele vivarisid mele nanige gottiddadu ella nanige marthu hoyitu andre gottiddadu mattu mariyudu eradu opposite ideas. But eradu opposite ideas ottige seridaga ondu hosa effect adakke bartade. Similarly here, your children are not your children. Two opposite ideas joined together, and they created a wonderful effect. And this is an example for a figure of speech called oxymoron, rarely used, but here Khalil Gibran has used this figure of speech quite effectively. I have told you already, what does your children are not your children mean? It means they do not belong to parents only. Children should have their own space. Parents should not be possessive of their children. Dear students, which is the correct answer? Which option is the right option for this question? Your children are not your children. Is the answer they do not belong to parents only is correct? Or children should have their own space is correct? Or parents should not be possessive of their children is the right answer? According to me, all the three options are acceptable. They are the correct answers.